Hi, guys. Fear not.
So we're looking at day 30 of Fear Not. In case you didn't know, I'm trying to commit to 365 examples of Fear Not from the Bible. These are none of my ideas. This is an old idea from many people. And I'm just trying to get through 365 days to see if I could help somebody. I know I'm learning a lot. But right now, we're in Ecclesiastes 11. And I'll just show you the verse. Verse 10. So remove sorrow from your heart and keep pain away from your body, because childhood and the prime of life are fleeting. If you remember back when you were a teenager, and you first begin to have your body fall apart and hurt or whatever, and you're thinking, what is this? I thought I was going to be able to run forever. Well, when it says prime of life, in some versions, it actually says black hair is fleeting. I know too much about that. But what's important is that you need to remove the sorrow from our heart. Sometimes that could be referred to as the evil. And keep the pain or the impurities from our body, because your life is fleeting. It says we'd spend so much time trying to figure out how to fix it, and not enough time figuring out how to enjoy it while we have it. Here in that same chapter in verse 5. Just as you do not know the path of the wind and how the bones are formed in the womb of a pregnant woman, so you do not know the activity of God who makes everything. So let's say you sprained your ankle as a kid and you're trying to figure it all out. Know that there's bigger things that are happening, and God is using everything, even the pain that you might be feeling. God works in ways we don't always understand his activity in our lives, but it's all for his will and his good. Know that your little amount of time where you're strong and young and not perfect is just like a leaf blowing in the wind. It's gone. Before you know it, you're in a state of falling apart, and then believe it or not, you're going to probably be dead and buried a long more time than you're going to be alive. Before you're raised from the dead because of baptism in Jesus, that time you could be in the grave for a lot longer than you actually lived. But here's the good news. The good news is after that in the kingdom, being raised into a different body. Let's see here. I got my next verse. In verse 7 in that same chapter. No, I'm sorry. Verse 8. Indeed, if a person lives many years, let him rejoice in them all. But let him remember the days of darkness. Remember, looks like I cut it off. So, conclusion, fear not. Because this little amount of time, this little amount of pain, is nothing compared to the direction that God has in your life. We may not understand it at the time, just like we may not understand how a baby is being formed, a life is being stitched together by God in a mother's womb. Or we may not, the pain might feel so big right now, but there's bigger things going on that will impact you longer. You're going to be dead a lot longer than you're going to be alive until you're raised from the dead in the kingdom. So fear not. This little amount of time, enjoy it and Look for God's will so you could excel in it. All right, fear not. That was Ecclesiastes 11. That's the same chapter as the bread on the waters, but hopefully I gave you a little bit a different take for you to just concentrate on fearing not for verse 10. So remove sorrow from your heart and keep pain away from your body, because childhood and the prime of life are fleeting, a short time.